The new M4 MacBook Airs are here and they are amazing. Now when you go to buy them, there are several different things that you have to choose between, both SSD size, processor, RAM, and a few other options as well. So in this video, we're gonna walk through buying a MacBook Air to help you know all the different choices that you have to make. Now, if you wanna skip this video, I do have links in the description for my favorite models, depending on what your profession is. So you can go there and see the links for all of my favorite configurations of the MacBook Air. Now, if we go to Apple's website, to me, this is the easiest way to see all the different choices that we have. The first thing you're gonna be greeted with is either getting the 13-inch or the 15-inch model. So this one is the 15-inch, and I really like the 15-inch size because it gives you some extra screen real estate. But the biggest problem with the 15-inch is it's gonna weigh just over half a pound more, and it's also gonna take up more space in your backpack. So if you're on the go a lot, if you're really traveling, working at a ton of coffee shops, then you might appreciate the size of the 13-inch because it's gonna be more portable. But if you're using this more often in a fixed environment, the 15-inch is gonna be a better option for you because it'll give you more real estate to get work done. So decide what you wanna get. Also, if you do get the 15-inch, that's automatically gonna upgrade the GPU on the computer over what the stock one is, which is a $99 upgrade on the 13-inch. So it's just $100 more basically to get the 15-inch screen over the same version of the 13-inch. The 13-inch has three main base models available. You can either get the stock one that comes in right at about $1,000, and it only has an 8-core GPU, and then you can also get the middle of the ground one that upgrades the GPU to 10 cores and also upgrades to 512 gigabytes of storage, or you could also get the third version that has 24 gigabytes of RAM. My recommendation is, if you can swing it, I would get the one in the middle with the 10-core GPU and 512 gigabytes of storage, because that's gonna give you more wiggle room for your apps or large files. 256 gigabytes is enough if you're doing most everything on the cloud, or if you're mostly just doing word processing or other basic tasks that don't require many files on your computer. But in today's day and age, 256 gigabytes is pretty small, especially with high resolution photos. So I would say the 512 is the one that I would really push you towards buying if you're able to swing it. Also, the 10-core GPU is gonna be a nice little upgrade for you as well, just to give you a little bit more graphics power and performance. But if you start with the 8-core model, the first thing you're gonna have to choose between is if you get the 8-core GPU or the 10-core GPU. The 10-core is gonna have just a little bit better graphics performance. It's not a big deal, but it is a nice little upgrade. And then once you get that, you have to choose how much RAM you get. So the old MacBook Airs only came with 8 gigabytes of RAM, and now Apple has actually upgraded it to start at 16. So 16 is gonna be perfectly fine for most users. I would say 99% of users are gonna be just fine with 16 gigabytes of RAM. Really where 24 is gonna help is if you do a lot of multitasking. Think tons of apps open at the same time. Beyond just having a bunch of Chrome tabs or Safari tabs, the 24 will be a very nice upgrade for you then. And then I would get the 32 gigabytes of RAM if you're using this computer for any sort of professional software-based work beyond word processing or OneNote or other apps like that. If you're gonna be using Lightroom or Photoshop or any kind of video editing at all, 32 gigabytes is gonna be much appreciated. Now I do wanna say all those apps will support 16 or 24 as well, but 32 is gonna give you a lot more headroom on your performance. So just decide what type of work you do. If you're just doing mainly word processing, 16 gigabytes is gonna be fine for you. If you're doing more advanced productivity work, get 24. But if you need to have even more power, that's when you need 32. And then on storage, we said 256 gigabytes is really only good if you're mostly doing cloud tasks. I would say 512 gigabytes should be the bare minimum, and that's also gonna upgrade your GPU for you. So that's a really good upgrade to me, is to get that 512. Then get the 1 terabyte if you're a photographer or if you're a videographer, because you're gonna appreciate having more space on your computer for large file types. Most people are not gonna need the 2 terabytes. Unless you really know you want to store a ton of footage or files on your computer. The last choice you have to make is the power adapter. So Apple has either the 70 watt or the 35 watt dual power adapter, which the 35 watt is going to charge your computer slow, but it gives you 2 USB-C ports. But the big problem with this is it's only 35 watts and that's split between both ports. So if you want to charge your phone and a computer at the same time, it's not gonna be able to keep up with the load on the computer. So in my opinion, it doesn't really matter what you pick. You could get the convenience of having the second port, but I would say most people should get the 70 watt power adapter because that's gonna be able to charge your computer faster. But the 35 watt is smaller, so it'll take up less space in a backpack. But I would really push you to go buy something like the Anker laptop charger. I'm gonna have links for it in the description because that has way more power and it has 4 USB ports on it to keep all your Apple devices charged at the same time. So My recommendation would be to go pick that up separately. And then on the pre-installed software, you can either choose to get Final Cut or Logic Pro pre-installed, which adds extra money, or not. My recommendation is do not get those pre-installed. If you know you're going to use those apps, go buy them later. Or if you already own it, then you can just download it from the cloud whenever you put your Apple ID into your computer. Also, there's free trials available on both of these. So it's better to just get the computer, set it up, try those apps out before you commit to buying them. I hope this video has helped you decide which MacBook Air you should get. For specific recommendations for all types of professionals, from college students to creative professionals to productivity workers, I'm going to have links for all my favorite models in the description below. I'm also going to have links for my favorite MacBook accessories. And if you need any personalized advice on buying a MacBook, I'm also going to have a contact form. Feel free to shoot me a message and I'd love to help you pick out a computer that's going to be the best option for you. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content. If you got any other questions or if you disagree with me, leave a comment down below.